Om Shanti. We are starting a new Murli, 31st December 2003, ninth point in the series of Mera Baba. Put wings of courage on those souls. The heading is, Put wings of courage on those souls. Nowadays, on the one hand, people want some attainment for themselves, but they lack courage. They don't have courage. They want to hear everything, but they don't have the courage to become that. In order to transform such souls, first of all, put wings of courage on those souls. The basis of the wings of courage is experience. Give them an experience. Experience is such that when they receive even a drop and experience something, then whether you call it the wings of experience or the feet of experience, They will be able to move forward with courage through that. For this, especially this year, you have to become endless, constant, great donors. Akhand Mahadani. Endless, constant, great donors. Make them into the embodiments of power through your mind. Become a great donor. Mahadani. And constantly give the experience of powers through your mind and your vibrations. Through your words, give the donation of knowledge. Through your deeds, donate virtues. Throughout the whole day, whether it is through your thoughts, words or deeds, in all three forms, become endless great donors. Akhand Mahadani. According to the time, you must not just become a donor who only donates sometimes. No. Become an endless donor, because souls need this. So Baba is telling, nowadays on one hand people want some attainments for themselves, but they don't have the courage. They lack courage. They don't have the courage. They want to hear everything, but they don't have the courage to become that. In order to transform such souls, first of all, put wings of courage on those souls. Give them wings. The basis of the wings of courage is experience. Give them an experience. Experience is such that when they receive even a drop, anchali, and experience something, then whether you call it the wings of experience or the feet of experience, they can't walk, Baba says. Give them feet of experience or wings of experience. They will be able to move forward with courage through that. For this, especially this year, you have to become endless, constant, great donor. So you have to become donor. You have to donate. What you have to donate? Three things. Powers through mind and vibrations. Knowledge through speech. And virtues through your deeds. Empower soul through our minds, through our vibrations, to make them knowledgeful, knowledgeable through our words, and to donate virtues through our elevated actions. This is to become great donor. And people do not have, souls don't have courage, though they understand everything, but they don't have the courage. You have to give them feet of experience or wings of experience. With this experience, they will muster up some courage. But for all these things, there are certain basic things which are needed. So what are the qualifications which are required to become a great constant donor? What things are required? How a person should be for becoming a great donor? Yes, Shyam Bhai. You have to have all the attainments yourself, fulfill yourself. If you are empty, if you are vacant within, if you are having that spiritual vacuum inside, you yourself are like an empty boat. How can you carry others ashore? So first of all, you should be full of all treasures. You should be full of all attainments. You should be full of all fortune. You should be full of all elevated memories. Then only you can donate that to others. So first requirement, first criteria is we should be full ourselves. One. Second, we should be merciful. We should be full of compassion for the whole world. Look at the world and look at their state. They are drowned in sorrow, in misery, in suffering, in depression, in frustration, in anxiety, in fear, in stresses and tensions, in sorrow, in peacelessness. Not an iota of peace, not a drop of love in their lives. They are so loveless and so hopeless and so peaceless. So what we should have is that elevated vision and that feeling of being merciful, compassion. Not just sympathy, but empathy. Okay, then what are the other things required to become a great donor? Unlimited vision. You should have unlimited vision. Not just thinking of my family, my children, my husband, my wife, my relatives. These are limited vision. My society, my center, my place, my state, my country. Unlimited means the whole world is your home. That unlimited vision. Just as Baba, when he comes and sits, he doesn't see only those people who are sitting. We have heard him so many times, he saying him double gathering. Baba has said, this is double gathering. Baba is seeing double gathering today. Baba is pleased to see double gatherings. First, those who are sitting here personally, physically, and those who are not there at all. Baba is also seeing them. So, such unlimited vision is required to become a great donor. Fourth, unconditional love. Love for all. You have to go above likes and dislikes. Sunday's Murli. Second point, anger. To have dislike for somebody is trace of anger. To have dislike for somebody means you are making him fall down. To have dislike for somebody means you are giving him final certificate by saying that he will never change. This likes and dislikes, this preferences, you have to rise above them. And you have to have unconditional love for everyone. Everyone. No matter what their past is, no matter what they are doing at present, but such unlimited love for all. Then, next, qualifications, Arvind Bhai. What are the qualifications of great donor? Mahadani, Akhandadani. What things are required here? Yes? Every moment, but what are the qualifications for that? That is the question. Is having big heart, magnanimous, generous heart, big heart, magnanimous personality, who gives to everyone. A narrow heart, doesn't know giving. All contractions is death, all expansion is life. Swami Vivekananda has said somewhere, all contraction is death, all expansion is life. To have tubular vision, to have prejudiced mind, such a person can never become great donor. For becoming great donor, you should have generous heart, a big heart, a heart that accommodate everyone's faults and failings. No matter what they are, still to have such a heart. So big heart is needed for becoming great donor. And same as big heart, pure feelings and good wishes, Shubha Bhavana and Shubha Kamna, not for one or two, for everyone. Your heart probably is lacking good wishes and pure feelings. That's why instead of becoming constant and endless donor, we become donor sometimes, and sometimes we try to hoard things, amass things. Contraction happens. This spiritual systole, let it be in diastole. Heart has got contraction and relaxation, systole and diastole. Let it relax. Let it expand. So, next, what are the qualifications of great donor? Dedication to donate, of course. You should be dedicated to this work. Just as you have dedication for other things, you should be dedicated to this thing. In Israel, there are two lakes. One is, they are actually lakes, but they are known as sea. Dead Sea and Sea of Galilee. Dead Sea and Sea of Galilee. Only one river supplies, pass through both of them. Jordan. River Jordan. Dead Sea is absolutely saline, hyper saline, very much salty, 10 times more than usual seas. No vegetation, no marine life. You can't drink that water. You can't do anything with that. That's why it is known as Dead Sea. You can swim. That is another thing. Yeah. So, no need to do any efforts. But, regarding for this reason, beauty, why it is known as Dead Sea? It is known as Dead Sea. Why? Because Jordan River comes and there is no outflow. There is another sea, Sea of Galilee. So fresh, so beautiful. All marine life, all vegetations. Because the river comes and goes through that. I'm talking in different spiritual sense. As if this person, this Dead Sea, it's not willing to give. It's hoarding. That's why it has become Dead Lake. While the Sea of Galilee, it's so beautiful, so serene, so fresh. People love to go there and see it. This is an analogy for being a donor. When you give, whatever you have, that increases. When you give, you become more beautiful. You become more fragrant. So that is the beauty of giving. In spiritual finance is quite different from worldly finance. Spiritual account is quite different from worldly accounts. In that world, when you give something, it becomes less. In this world, in this account, in this spiritual finance, in this spiritual economics, when you give something, it rises exponentially. It rises. It doesn't decrease. The entire mathematics is different here. This is spiritual mathematics. So that is why you should have big heart. You should have generous heart. And selfless. Whatever you give, you should give with an attitude of selflessness. Altruistic feeling. If you give with selfish end in your mind, that may not give you that much merit as is required, as is expected. So that's why, give with selfless heart. And then, what are the qualifications of great donor? Give respect. Okay. Today's slogan, I think, is like that.
Same, no?
Yeah. Raise self-respect is on. Slogan is about giving self-respect. Okay. And getting situated yourself in self-respect. Okay. Then, what all things are required for giving something? Know what is required. What other souls need. That knowledge is also necessary. We should give them what is needed for them. Not what we want to give. Not that what we want to give. Brother Shyam had once given a very good example in the form of a story. One teacher in the classroom once told that you have to do some charitable work. So the students went home, and next day when the teacher asked what charitable work you did, first student said that there was a blind woman standing and I helped her crossing the road. The teacher asked other student what you did. He said there was a blind woman standing and I helped her cross the road. Teacher was surprised. There are two blind women at the same time. He asked the third student what you did. He said there was a blind woman standing and I helped her cross the road. He says, how come all of you found a blind woman and helping that blind woman to cross the road? One student said, actually woman was same and she did not want to cross. We dragged her across the road. Don't do such sort of donation. So that's not a donation. We should know what people want, what is their need, understand what they require, what they need, and give them what they want. This existence is rich. This existence is very rich. And everybody will get what one wants if that desire is very earnest. A deep, earnest desire. Ask and he shall receive. Knock and it shall open. Seek and he shall find. This is a very deep philosophy hidden in these words of Jesus Christ. Knock and it shall open. But are we knocking properly? Seek, search, and he shall find. Ask, and he shall receive. And this is the rule of existence, that whosoever desires something very deeply in his heart of hearts, that thing comes to that person. So now we have to come in between and help that person to receive, to get what he wants. If he wants peace, we cannot give him teachings of. Somebody wants to pass in exam and we are teaching him importance of celibacy, he will reject us. If he wants peace and we start telling him history of beginning, middle and the end of the world, he may not like it. So that is why understand what they want, what is their need, what is their innermost desire, and then fulfill that. You should be able to diagnose what disease they are suffering from. Then only we can give them proper injections, proper treatment. If our very diagnosis is wrong, probably we are doing more harm to him. So, become a constant, endless donor. Akhand Mahadani. They just want a drop, anchali. Not more than that. But we have to give them. We have to become. And they need experience, Baba says. Give them feet of experience and wings of experience so that they can fly, so that at least they can walk with those feet of experience. And then they will feel courageous. Then that courage will take birth in their heart. And they will turn towards spirituality. Now they are drowned in materialism. Epicurean philosophy. Eat, drink and be happy. Charvak philosophy. There was one philosopher in India who was named by the name Charvak. His philosophy says, eat, drink and be happy. There is no need of God. Why you are unnecessarily wasting your time in worship? That philosophy is known as Charvak philosophy. Eat, drink and enjoy. Merry. Just enjoy life. Get drowned in materialism. Whatever you want to eat, eat. Whatever you want. What you want to drink, drink. Marry as many times as possible. Whatever you want, do it. That is Charvak philosophy. In Western world, this is known as Epicurean philosophy. There was Epicurean diet, you must have heard. Overindulgence. So, people are drowned in that and we have to give them courage so that they turn towards spirituality. So, today's homework is qualifications of a great, endless, constant donor. Akhand Mahadani. What are they? Just write down and churn them. Think over them and become an embodiment. Om Shanti.